a beautiful day. And the people I'm going to look at today, well, I'm not actually going to look at them. Let's say I'm going to visit them. Tyrone Power. I want to find him first. And then there's Judy Garland, who's also here. John Huston, who's my director crush. And then Victor Fleming is here too. Who else? Peter Lorre. Clifton Webb. Marion Davies is here too. Fay Wray. So we'll see. Oh, peacocks. Hello. Hi. Can you lead me to Tyrone Power's grave? Hey, oh, there. Okay. Thank you. You can just lead me all the way. I'm just gonna follow you guys. Look how pretty you are. I'm probably gonna cry, actually. Because I think I see it. I'm not gonna show you that I'm crying. I'm not crying, but... Oh, look, a squirrel. Hi there. So cute. Look how beautiful. Well, Tyrone certainly has a beautiful resting place, huh? Yeah, I can see his grave. It's the one that looks like a bench. I'm here.
So this is one of Tyrone's favorite passages from Hamlet.
And here's like masks.
And there you can see traces of lipstick.
And this is actually meant as a bench, you know. Sometimes people are afraid to sit on it because they're like, I can't just sit on this grave. But it's actually meant to be sat on. And Cesar Romero said that it is designed as a bench because he wants Tyrone to have people sitting on his face, even in death, which of course is a sexual reference. I think Ty was a little kinky, so.
Well, now you know my secret.
I am gonna sit on it. So I don't know where his face is. Don't lick my ass, Ty, okay? And here I am. So I thought I could just draw him a flower. I basically have to do it while holding a camera. Now, Tyrone Power, he died when he was only 44. And he died in Madrid, in Spain, in the middle of shooting a film. He was shooting a fight scene with George Sanders and had a heart attack. I'm trying to fucking talk about Hollywood history here, bitches. Oh my God. Literally. He was still, this looks terrible. I don't like this flower. What am I doing? I don't think Tyrone will like this. Let me try to draw a better one. So anyways, he had a heart attack at 44 in the middle of shooting a scene with George Sanders, fell down on the floor and then died on the way to the hospital. Like, he had been feeling a little unwell before that already, and he had his heart checked up. He had an echocardiogram at one point, and then something didn't look quite right on it, and so the doctor wanted to have, you know, wanted to do further testing. And apparently Tyrone said, if there's anything I don't want to know. I don't want to know, and I don't want to have further testing. Either way, he also had a wish, a desire to die just like his father, whom he admired really, really very much. And he was a famous stage actor, his father. And his father died performing on stage. And Tyrone was actually there, and his father basically pretty much died in his arms. He wanted to die performing just like his father. And I think actually his grandfather was also an actor. You know, Tyrone Power came from a famous acting dynasty. His grandfather, I think he also died on the stage. So he just had this kind of desire to follow that history, I think. And so his wish was granted. He died doing what he loved. And Tyrone truly loved to act. And he was very, very frustrated with the possibilities he was given. You know, he was never allowed to be more than just the handsome prince or the glamorous star, you know, and he was so longing to be more than that. And so his favorite movies are the few movies that really let him show what a great actor he was, and that was Nightmare Alley and The Razor's Edge, which is my favorite Tyrone Power film. So once the 50s came around, he did, you know, he went to New York and he did a lot of Broadway theater. So he really could act there, and I think he was very happy doing that. And the people who saw him live on the stage said that he was just amazing. Yeah, he had this beautiful voice, which he wasn't even fully allowed to use in movies. Like, a director would only let him get angry to a point. You know, he was never truly allowed to be really intense or menacing. And it was so frustrating to him, because he had a great intensity.
And who are you? The captain of this band? Who's handling these jobs, you or me or somebody else? Well, I'll tell you if you don't know, it's me. I'm doing it, see? And I'll ride up the Capitol steps if I feel like it.
But he was very beloved amongst actors and in the Hollywood community. He was a very good person, very sensitive. He loved reading, he loved books, he loved language. He wrote really beautifully himself. I'm sorry, I'm recovering from a cold. Something is missing here. I need color here. A little pink. Yellow.
Well, the one with Betty Davis. I don't remember.
It's Crawford.
Yeah, it's Crawford and Davis. I don't remember it too well. I saw it a while ago.
You mind if I let them loose?
No.
Run a little bit. Look at your exercise.
Hi. Come here. Hi. Oh, you're so cute.
Oh, that's okay. I don't mind a little barking.
Christmas in LA is always so surreal because people are telling each other Merry Christmas on the street and in the stores, and you're like, it's summer. It's not Christmas. When I last lived in LA, I wasn't a fan of old movies, believe it or not. So when I lived here last, I didn't visit any graves because I didn't have an interest in all that stuff. And Tyrone is actually the first grave. I visited, or I'm visiting, since I arrived in L.A. Tyrone Power. It's a great poem. Watch out. Tyrone Power is my favorite, can you guess? Flower. Should I sign it? Now, where do I put it?
Roll it up like this so you can see the flower. And I can either put it here.
Should I put it there?
I'm gonna put it here.
It's less intrusive.
Bye, Ty.
Gonna see you again, I know. This is a beautiful place to just come and sit, but you gotta catch the early morning sun. Bye, my love. This is that grave of, I think it's a little exaggerated, of Anton Yelkin. He has this statue. It's a little pompous. Doesn't really look like him either. And look at that beautiful Art Deco. It's just, Oh, Mickey Rooney. I mean, I'm not really a Mickey Rooney fan. Just, he died only not that long ago. He was one of the greatest entertainers, though. He really could do everything. Oh, and here's Toto. Remember Toto from The Wizard of Oz? He's buried here. Oh, he's not buried here. Her? Toto was a girl? She suffered a lot on that movie. I do know that they put her through quite an ordeal.
Now I found her.
Oh wow, look at that. Over the rainbow. Judy Garland was actually buried somewhere in New York up until very recently. I think they only brought her back here in like 2 years ago, 2017, I think. And that's where she's resting now. There's a book you can sign. Dear Judy Garland, when I saw your movie, I liked it so much. It was an inspiration to me. And this Halloween, I dressed up like you and my dog was Toto. That's so cute. I don't know what to write to her. I don't have like an obsession with her or like a particularly personal connection. What should I write her? Dear Judy, you were simply a smash. She actually was in a relationship for a while with Tyrone Power. Wow, I'm taking up too much space.
Oh, I could. Just a little something.
Wow, look at that beautiful writing. Somewhere over the rainbow, may you find peace and eternal rest. A star is born, a star is lost. A voice as sweet as your soul. A true gem you were. Merry Christmas, Judy. Oh God, it's not November, it's December. Oh God, my brain. Well, she was a genius. A true, true artist.
The road gets rougher. It's lonelier and tougher. With hope, you burn up. Tomorrow he will turn up. There's just no let up. The live long night and day.
Legendary. I hope you can still feel the love the world still has for you. You remain alive in so many ways. I always tear up when I read stuff like that. Yeah, Fred Astaire is mentioned here. Easter Parade, my most favorite movie. Thank you, Judy. You were great partners with Fred. They loved each other, Fred and Judy. They actually have something in common, too. Fred Astaire died on June 22nd, 1987, much later than Judy Garland, but they actually shared the same anniversary. Look at this architecture. Oh my God. Just for the architecture, it's worth coming here. I believe that Sanctuary of Peace is the one where Clifton Webb is. Let's go see. Look how beautiful this is. I love the pink. Matches my fingernails. There he is! Shh! He's actually said to be haunting this place. People have seen his ghost around. He's sitting over there on the chair, making sarcastic remarks.
Oh, here you are. Lorre, dear, I cannot stand these morons any longer.
The most acid tongue in old Hollywood, and almost always the best thing about any movie he was in. He's probably best remembered for starring alongside Gene Tierney and Dana Andrews in Lorre, but he was also in The Razor's Edge with Tyrone Power.
Oh, hello. Larry, I thought you were dead.
Sorry to disappoint you.
Hi. This here is actually called the Douglas Fairbanks lawn. And in the summertime, they show movies here. And they project the movies onto this wall. And people just sit here. I guess this is the Fairbanks grave. Now look at this grave. Well, that's certainly one hell of a grave. So this is Douglas Fairbanks and Douglas Fairbanks Jr. You can see the Hollywood sign. I don't know if you can see it from here. Let me zoom in, zoom, zoom, zoom. Misery, you got to go. I've actually never seen a Douglas Fairbanks movie because he made the sort of movie I'm not really that interested in. You know, he did a lot of like silent swashbuckler films and other type of silent adventure films. Douglas Fairbanks Jr., though, I've seen in quite a few films. Quite like him. Well, there's another view of the Fairbanks. Great. Oh, wow. Oh, dear. I want to swim there. What are you yapping about? And there you can see Tyrone's grave from here. And this is where Marion Davies is, in that tomb. Great comedian of the 20s and 30s. Here, pretty much, well, yeah, on the other side of the lake from where Tyrone is Fay Wray, who was in the King Kong movie.
Say, I guess I love you.
Why, Jack, you hate women.
Yeah, I know.
Great actress. I've seen her in a few other things. I'm interested to explore her more, actually. Oof. This is very cold and dark. Not as friendly as the other one. And here's supposed to be Peter Lorre somewhere. Oh, there's a picture of him. Oh, and Zeus is buried here too. Who knew that Zeus was buried in Hollywood? I think he's down here. Yeah. I think he was cremated. I mean, obviously, it's a little grave. I don't think his last years were very happy. I think he developed a morphine addiction and, died of a stroke, I think. Peter Lorre, great actor. Can you help me find a grave? Do you know?
Is a celebrity?
John Huston.
Oh, his is kind of difficult. Way down there, there's that one with the four posts, with the four pillars.
Yeah.
To the right of it, there's two bushes. There's one, they're not flowering now, but one of them has like a peach-colored flowers and the other one yellow. He's under the one that has yellow. So you'd have to get in there and probably wipe it on the back. But it's like this. So you'd have to kind of clean it a little.
I think I found it. Oh my God. I think that's it. Yeah. Oh my God. I'm on my knees. For John Huston, I mean, there could be worse things, I guess. That's John Huston's grave. Buried with his mother, Rhea Huston. 1906, died in 1987, same year as Fred Astaire. Lost a few great ones in 1987, but yeah, an Irish art. He, of course, spent a good amount of time in Ireland, which he loved. But yeah, talk about hidden. So you get an idea, it's under there. Found this one totally by accident. It's Janet Gaynor. She's also under a tree, a little hidden. Right now I'm looking for Victor Fleming. Flemmy, as I call him. Still haven't found him. Flemmy. A lot of dead people. But no Flemmy. So I'm still looking for Victor Fleming. I'm not kidding. I've been walking around for like almost an hour now. Among the spirits. I'm getting a little tired and it's a lot of... I'm very sensitive, so it's a lot of energy you're absorbing. The times where I walk to the ends of the earth for a guy are over. 1 hour is enough. That's my limit now, but I'm so determined. This bugs the hell out of me. I'm too stubborn to let it go. Flemmy. Do you know where Victor Fleming is?
Victor what?
I said I walked through it one more time, and now I'm already walking through it the third time. It's Clifton Webb again. Hi. What? Oh, here he is. Born in 1889, died in 1949. I actually didn't know that he died so young. Well, he lived a pretty wild life, I guess. And that would be his wife and his daughter. One of the greatest directors of the classic era, but very rarely mentioned, actually, when people talk about the great directors of the Golden Age. Not sure why that is. I mean, he only directed Gone with the Wind and The Wizard of Oz in the same year, but never mind. So the cemetery is actually right behind Paramount Studios. I hope we can see it. I can't see a thing because the sun is so bright. Let's just hope it zooms in. I don't know if you can see all these cats here. They don't have a home. And they feed them and they... Look. Ah! Hi there. I'm not gonna do anything to you. No worries. Something else lying there. Probably a rattlesnake. What is this? No, it's not a snake. Oh, somebody brought something. A dirty kitchen towel for Inez Morgan. My darling wife. Maybe he wants to tell her to come back and clean his kitchen. There's a swing there. I love this place. It's such an oasis of calm and peace in the middle of the hustle and bustle of Hollywood. Because like, if you've ever been to Hollywood, Hollywood is not a glamorous place. You know, it's dirty and loud and kind of dingy. And then you step into the cemetery and it's so beautiful and pretty and quiet, and the lawn is perfectly trimmed. A real refuge. I'm leaving the cemetery. You can see the Hollywood sign. And here, the traffic, an entirely different thing. As soon as we turn a corner, it's no more fancy, glamorous buildings. It's just Hollywood, baby. Cute.